Imagine drugs so powerful that taking them immobilizes you, makes you lose control of your body, and turns you into a babbling mess. Imagine also that buying these drugs is as easy as buying a digital camera online, and in many states, just as legal. This is the situation with dozens of herbs, seeds, powders, and extracts from plants sold online. In the United States, selling most of these substances breaks no federal drug laws. State laws are a different story, though. One of the most popular substances, salvia, is already illegal in several states, and bills that would outlaw it are pending in several others. Dozens of sites with names like Bouncing Bear Botanicals, Purple Sticky Brand, and SalviaSupply.com sell these substances, though many warn that they are not intended for human consumption. And salvia isn't the only thing for sale. One site sells what it calls magic mushrooms. Another site sells poppy seeds, but charges nothing for tips on how to turn them into a tea that the site says can deliver a strong opium-like high. The people in these videos may not appear to be having a good time, but this is what they look like when taking the hippest new hallucinogen, Salvia divinorum. In Mexico, salvia has been used for centuries in religious ceremonies by shamans seeking to connect to the spirit world. Today, it's sold online under names such as Sally D. Two tokes and you're as high as a kite. To learn more about these substances, PC World went shopping online and purchased nearly two dozen psychoactive botanical products, all of which were legal in California, where our offices are. We then sent the products to the National Center for Natural Products Research at the University of Mississippi to be analyzed. This is Datura. We purchased 14 grams of it online for $18. Researchers at the University of Mississippi say Datura is highly toxic, and if you take too much, it could cause seizures, coma, and death. The University of Mississippi researchers say these mushrooms are potentially dangerous, capable of causing not only hallucinations, but nausea and kidney damage. So what does the Federal Drug Enforcement Agency say about this? Not much. DEA representatives told us the substances we bought are currently legal under federal law. However, they did say that salvia is currently under review to determine whether it should be classified as a controlled substance under federal law. Deaths allegedly related to ingesting these types of drugs are rare, but do occur. In January 2008, a 17-year-old boy from Santa Clara County, California, died of pulmonary edema related to what the coroner's report called an acute morphine and codeine intoxication. The boy's parents said their son died after drinking poppy seed tea. Ingredients and a recipe for this brew can easily be found online. In 2007, a 15-year-old Albuquerque, New Mexico boy, William Hodge, was found floating just beneath the surface of Elephant Butte Lake in New Mexico. Authorities say he drowned after drinking Datura tea with two friends during a campout. When Delaware teenager Brett Chidester committed suicide in 2006, his parents were convinced his use of salvia in the months before his death was to blame. Several months after Chidester's death, local authorities updated his death certificate to list salvia as a contributing cause of death. Chidester's parents successfully lobbied Delaware lawmakers to classify salvia as a Schedule I controlled substance, making possession, use, or consumption of the drug a misdemeanor in that state. It's worth noting that while many of the sites that sell these powerful herbs provide tips on how to ingest them, they also display disclaimers stating clearly that these products are sold for research purposes only and are not meant for human consumption. Still, Brett Chidester's parents are suing the company they believe responsible for selling their son salvia online. Owners of sites we contacted defended their sales of psychoactive substances. They say adults should have the right to do what they choose with their body. And in many states, the law is on their side, at least for now. I'm Ed Albro. Thanks for watching.